Everybody, it's Lou. Well, I was supposed to make this video from the flip camera, but I don't know, my camera's tripping. I think my sister got insurance on it, so we'll probably have to take it back tomorrow and see why it's suddenly, as soon as I changed the battery, it just started tripping. I don't know. So back to the webcam, which is giving me problems. See, the color and I don't know, it's just giving me a lot of problems lately. Well, I'm not gonna be able to vlog tonight, so I just went ahead and did a vlog, so please forgive me for slacking off, but like I said, I'm on vacation, so. Okay. Today is St. Patrick's Day, and I have green on, as you can see. No pinching here. My daughter, I didn't have green on earlier, and so my daughter was kind of giving me crap about it. She's like, "Oh, I'm gonna pinch you," and she did a little booger pinch me, because she had green on, of course, and so she knows the rules. See the camera? God, my camera's awful. Yes, I'm still smoking. Yeah, so St. Patrick's Day. And today is also my nephew's birthday. He turns 15. And today, my sister and I, well, my sister, she wanted to throw him a birthday party. Well, we went to go look for the decorations for the party. And my sister wanted to get him, like, birthday hats. And, like streamers and balloons and stuff, and I had to, when she picked up the birthday hats, I had to kind of stop her, and I had to tell her, like, you know, sister, you know, he's 15, the time for birthday hats and pin the tail on the donkey, that time is gone, you know, he's a big boy now, you know, he's 15, so it was kind of, you know, bittersweet for her, but yeah, we got some things, and I had to cook today, and I cooked for my nephew for his party, and the minute I started cooking, that's it, I was done for. I was doing good today. I didn't binge and purge at all. I had like maybe 350 calories. And but yeah, once I started cooking, that was it. My sister's friend, who is the hairdresser, was gonna come to the party, and also the neighbor next door. Both these women I've met, and they're lovely girls, and you know, now they're my friends too. They were gonna come tonight, and when I went to go cut my hair, the hairdresser had made a comment or something, like, because my sister and I were discussing diet pills. So the hairdresser made a comment like, "Oh, you need diet pills," and like in the sense of like you don't need them or something. And she made a comment like that. And the neighbor, the first night that I was here, that I had met her, the first night you know, I binged. I don't know. The neighbor, she saw me in the middle of a binge, so she made a comment like, "Oh my God, she's so skinny and all that she eats," or something like that. But they didn't, these comments didn't bother me. What bothered me was, well, they didn't bother me, that's the thing. But for some reason today, I felt the need to eat in front of these people, even though I would never see them again, or, you know. But I felt the need to eat in front of them. So what I did was, I got a little plate, and I basically, I got a little bit of everything and put it on my plate to eat it. Now, don't know. I felt like they were gonna look at my plate or something. I don't know. It was probably just me and like all in my head or whatever. But I felt as though like they were looking at what I was eating. I don't know. I don't know how to explain that. I don't know if anyone has ever had a moment like that. Like you're being watched. But like I said, I can't really tell you if I was or wasn't. I'm sorry, look for the lighter. If I was or wasn't being watched, but that's what it felt like. So, as you can see, I'm in the garage again, because this is where smokers are banished, and I don't mind it. It's the warmest room in the house. Other than that, I would have the jacket on. But yeah, I ate in front of these people. You know, everyone that was here. And I didn't like the feeling of the food in me. Even though it was a little bit of food that I ate, I didn't like it. So I went ahead and purged. And but I didn't purge all of it because there was a lot of people in and out the house, and I got real paranoid and I felt rushed, and I didn't even take my clothes off right then. I was just purging, like, with whatever I was wearing still. Because usually when I purge, you know, that's not how I purge. I have to have everything off, and that's how I know it's out, you know, by the weight or whatever. But anyways, yeah. So I was trying to drink and enjoy myself, and I did, but that's it, you know, the appetite began and the urges, and I went ahead and I had more because I had to get the rest out. So I had to eat some more to get the rest of it out. And my sister, the neighbor, stepped out for a second because everyone, by this time, everyone was leaving. And the neighbor was still around, but she had stepped out for a minute. I forget for what. And my sister was like, "Did you get everything out? You know, you're okay, you're straight." And I explained to her, and she was like, "Just, you know, just go purge and just, you know." And so that's what I did. I binge and purge again, and this time, you know, everything was out. But I'm okay. I'm not, like, the scale says the same weight and it doesn't say gain, but you know, I've just been eating these days, not a lot, but I've been eating more than what I usually eat, and even though the scale doesn't say, you know, more weight or whatever, I can tell that I've gained weight. I can tell in certain parts of me, I can see the gain. For instance, okay, I'm not a curvy girl. I'm not, guess I have boobs. But I also had a child, so before I'm not a big chested girl. I'm kind of boyish, I guess. I don't have hips or anything. I'm kind of, not even after I had a kid, you know, usually you pop out some hips after you have a baby, but I don't have that problem. The only time you see me with hips is I've gained a lot of weight. But I don't have hips today. I don't have a butt either. Like I have a butt, obviously, but you know, compared to most girls, I'm not, like, really, you know, like, I'm not curvy, not voluptuous or whatever. But I all these exercises and things that I do, you know, I have a little butt, but you know, it's not whatever. But and so now with all these things that I'm eating, I can tell where the weight is going, and now I have, you know, like a I guess more defined or whatever. This is odd. talking about my ass. But yeah, I can tell where the weight is going, and it's going there, and it's going also to my legs, to the muscle, and it's a little bit like it's more defined. So I can tell, where the weight is going and stuff, and but it's not bothering me as much. And also, what people say, that it doesn't bother me. Like, I'm having a great time on vacation. I'm really enjoying myself. I'm really happy and mellow. My sister made a comment today, about how she can tell that I'm different. Like, she told me, like, I can see a little piece of you from before the ED, and like I can see like a little piece of you, like you're getting something back, like your confidence back, like the old you is trying to come back. And I haven't had any panic attacks here. I haven't had any low sugar. I've been okay. I've been, I've been happy. I have been, this is the most that I've been laughing. I mean, I wake up laughing, and I go to sleep laughing and smiling, and it's great. And it's so quiet here, and it's really, even though you need a car up here because everything is far away, and my sister would ask me, "Oh, would you get acclimated, if you were to move up here?" And I was like, "Yeah, of course. I can get used to most anywhere. I've been shuffled around a lot these past 4 years. I haven't been in a place long enough that I could say this is my home. I had a home before, and I lost it, and but I haven't felt that homey feeling anymore. Where I'm living, I've been there 4 years, and it doesn't feel like home to me. It just feels like a transition. And but I can stay put, and I want to stay put somewhere eventually, and have that home feeling back. So but she was basically, because she wants me to live up here, and I would love to if I could, but right now, the way things are, and I just can't, move up here without being followed, and having a possible stalker scenario and such. And but being up here is good for me. It's good for my sanity. I haven't had those urges where I haven't had any urges or any inner voices just messing with me, and I feel really great. I feel happy. I like being around my family and around my sister. And my daughter loves it too. She loves to be near family, and it's great. It's been great. I get this rash on my neck, and I only get that when I get really stressed out or anxious. And basically, this rash on my neck, it's red blotches, but blotches on your neck look like hickeys. So I hate getting it, because when I would take my daughter to school, I would just get so paranoid. I mean, I can't wear a turtleneck, obviously, but when I take her to school, I just get so paranoid, because I think people are looking at me and judging me, and I'm probably like, "Oh my God, look at this slut," and she just sees a lot of action or something. And I just get really, I don't like those blotches on my neck. And I haven't had a breakout in a little bit. I get them, but they go away after a while. But I haven't had one recently, since the last breakout. And my sister today was noticing my neck, and she was telling me, that I had a blotch, and that it looked like a hickey. And she was kind of like, "Oh, did you, have a dude here or something?" But yeah, I don't understand why I would be getting a blotch on my neck now, stress related, because I'm not stressed. So the only thing I can think of is maybe, I'm getting closer to that time where I have to go back home, and I don't know, maybe my body is kind of getting geared up or such. I don't know. But I'm actually staying an extra day. I was supposed to leave Saturday, and I'm actually gonna leave Sunday. And which is cutting it close, because my daughter has school Monday. So yeah, it's going on 15 minutes. I'm sorry. I'm okay. Everything's good. I'm sorry I didn't vlog today, and I'm gonna wrap this up really fast. I want to say thank you to Cora for the award, and I hope everyone enjoyed the little details that I posted about myself. Yeah, happy St. Patrick's Day. I hope everyone's safe and don't drink too much and don't drink too much green beer, and no kissing leprechauns, and no drinking and driving, please. Yeah, I've been okay. I'm okay. And sorry for not vlogging tonight, but it's been a really nice day with my family, and just trying to, have a little drink and cigarette and get in the bed and probably catch up on some vlogs. Yeah, I'm okay. And tomorrow I'm gonna go play some pool and probably get in the swimming pool and gonna go see my friend, and that's about it. I'm okay, and I binged a purse today, but I'm gonna get down on it, and I'm on vacation, so I'm gonna just roll with the punches, and any gain or any damage or anything work that's been undone, I will deal with it when I go back home, and that's it. I need time away, and besides, when I get back home, I'm gonna start therapy. And I have an appointment with my therapist, and I'm sure it's gonna be new milestones, and I'm pretty excited, and I'll deal with everything when I get back home. So I hope everyone's having a nice St. Patty's Day, and I'll talk to you guys again tomorrow. And I'm sorry for the video, I really wanted to vlog, but it's getting late, and it's a birthday, and it was a birthday party, and so forgive me, please. And I'll see you guys again tomorrow, and I'll talk to you guys again tomorrow. So good night, everybody.